Before Columbus began in 1976, as primarily a distribution project, and we participated in book fairs throughout the United States and in Europe and Alaska. Of course, Alaska is part of the United States. We have also joined with 21 other magazines spread out through the country, Southwest, East, Northeast, South, different cultures, Chicano, Native American, Afro-American, Euro-American, Asian-American, Chicano, Hispanic, whatever, magazines, from My Age to Wybird Magazine to Telephone to The Unmuzzled Ox. And we've also instituted within the last year a reading program, which this is part of. In other words, we bring the poets to the people, and the people buy the books, right? We have books out there which were written by the poets who were reading tonight. So we started out with a reading program in San Francisco, the San Francisco Museum. We just concluded a successful reading program there. And then we went over to the Oakland Museum. Right now we're at the Oakland Museum. I'm sure all of you have heard of Oakland, California. That's where Jack London came from, right? Bret Hart. And we'll conclude that program with a reading by the great Chicano novelist Rudolfo Anaya, the author of Bless Me Altima, at the Oakland Museum on June 30th. We've also sponsored readings in Missouri and the state of Washington, in New Mexico, and tonight we're sponsoring this reading. I don't want to make a big speech about what Before Columbus is all about, except that we do feel that there are traditions that begin before the arrival of Columbus to Espanola, and we feel that a revisionist or another look at American culture, American history, would date our traditions back 30,000 years, or even longer. There's a Native American writer named Leslie Silko who just wrote a book called, or just published a book called Ceremony, which relies on oral traditions of the Southwest, which go back thousands of years, 30,000 years. So it's a broader view of American culture that we subscribe to. We include the major cultures because we feel that only great poets, especially epic poets, are only created when poets are aware of all the cultures. And so tonight we present an anthology of all the cultures of the United States, representative from different cultures, different regions, all together in like a national poetry anthology. The first reader, and each reader will read about 10 minutes. The first reader is the vice chairman of the Before Columbus Foundation, who just compiled a brilliant catalog of all the presses we are, including all the presses we're representing. 62 presses, 250 titles, 22 magazines. And we have a brochure for those who want to adopt 70 or 80 copies of each book for your classes. We have a brochure outside for sale, or an announcement, which is for free outside on the table there. I think Robert Callahan is one of those people, a multicultural poet, who's not just content with one tradition, became bored and restless in one tradition, who is the chairman of the Turtle Island Foundation. There's another name for it, but I can't pronounce it right. But he has recently published a book called Appalachia by George Paul Metcalf, who is Herman Melville's great-grandson. And along with a number of other distinguished titles. And he's, I guess he's like a one-man band. Some of us are originally New Yorkers, so the people out on the West Coast call us one-man bands or something like that, right? And he does a lot of things. He's also an author. He is the author of Winter Poles, Algonquin Woods, just published, and the editor of a very fine multicultural magazine called New World Journal. And I would like to introduce the first reader tonight, Bob Callahan.